Jeremy, whenever you wanna begin, let me know.
All right, sounds good, just getting this up. All right, so we should be live, all right, cool.
How's everybody?
Good.
All right, that was weak, how's everybody?
Good.
Good?
All right, cool. So, just doing a live feed here on Facebook, and the reason why I wanted to do that too is I wanna kinda go over some things with you guys today and find out what you guys wanna know about real estate, what's real, what's not. And I wanna be real with you and tell you how you screw up, how you lose $200,000 in a deal, how you make a couple hundred grand in a deal, how you can make $1 million a year in real estate, or you can make about $15,000 and be bankrupt. So today, I just wanted to be real with you guys, give you guys some advice and find out what you guys wanna know about real estate. And the reason why I'm doing Facebook Live is, who watches fake real estate TV shows? Anybody watching those flipping TV shows? Right? All right. So back in 2005 or 2006, me and my buddy got selected for one, and I said, okay, I'll do it. I want the marketing, I want the publicity. Then he told me you're gonna make $3,000 per episode. And my one question was, how do I flip 10 houses in 10 months? They said, we don't care if you sell them. So I didn't do the TV show, right? Because I think it's pretty much a joke because it's fake, right? They're not really caring about how people are selling. So today what I wanna do with you guys is I wanna really find out what you wanna know about real estate. I have a little bit of agenda. Jackson, you grab my agenda real quick. I'm sorry, I forgot it. And find out what you guys wanna know about it. So what year are you guys in real estate? Most of you guys here in school. If you're a sophomore, raise your hand. If you're a junior, raise your hand. If you're a senior, raise your hand. If you're a fifth year senior, raise your hand. All right, so what, mostly sophomores and juniors? All right, cool. So let's start it off. So what do you guys wanna know about real estate? Jackson, can you just, we're gonna pick out the top three things that they wanna know, and we're gonna make sure we address them, okay?
Yep.
All right, cool. So give me something you guys wanna know about real estate.
How to make money.
Okay, how to make money. All right, that's one. What's another one?
Major differences between commercial and residential.
Okay, good. So major differences between commercial and residential. What's another one?
Working at a smaller firm or like a big corporate firm?
All right, working at a small firm versus a big firm. Let's go to five. Those are good questions. Anybody else? This is free. You can read a book and you can read, you know, 300 pages and try to figure out the three nuggets. I'll give them to you right now.
How to get like a loan for your first property or something with a lower income.
How to get into real estate investing, get a loan. So let's go over that one, Jackson. How to get real estate investing, how to build a portfolio.
How to select a great first investment property.
Okay. And then the last one was how to select the first great real estate property. All right, cool. All right, so who's from around Philadelphia area here? All right, about half of you. Anybody from Western PA? Where are you from?
Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh, all right, cool. So I'm from Punxsutawney, about 2 hours west of Pittsburgh. I went to Pitt originally, went to pharmacy school. Had no idea what I wanted to do. My dad's a pharmacist, got into pharmacy school and realized I didn't fit in. And I wasn't smart enough. So I dropped out, went to Penn State, met my wife, got into business, went something similar to you guys have here. I went to Smill Business School, graduated, got into telecommunications. I was horrible at that. Got into real estate in 2003, started flipping houses, became a part-time realtor, then got into it full-time in 2006, and then realized that the money potential in real estate. So for 6 years, I sold real estate as a team, and then for 6 years, I became a manager of a real estate office in Philadelphia. That office ended up becoming top 10 in recruiting and production out of 800 offices nationwide, and that office actually had a lot of success with Temple. A lot of success with Temple. If anybody asked me where was the number one group of people went to college that did well with us, it was Temple. Very interesting. And I had people from all different schools in Philadelphia in the suburbs and in other areas too. And then I've always flipped houses. I've always renovated houses, always kept rentals. And then in July this year, I partnered up with a group of guys, and the dad's the 33rd largest apartment owner in the United States of America. He's got $2 billion of real estate. He's got 40,000 apartments. He is number one or number two in Philadelphia apartments. He's on the fifth floor of our building in Old City. Fourth floor is Rittenhouse Realty. It's the largest commercial brokerage of multifamily in the area. Mr. Aller backed that. My good buddy Kenny and Corey are the owners of that, and then the regular person. And then TCS Management, I'm involved in that. That's the largest single family property management company in Philadelphia. That was created 3 years ago. We have 1,800 units under management, so I can help you with any questions on management. and then TCS Investments was created. I have nothing to do with Keller Williams Condo Shop. That's another brokerage that they have, 60 agents. I don't have anything to do with that. TCS Investments, I created that. We do four things. Turnkey properties. I can talk to you about real estate investing. You asked how to get involved in that. Flipping houses. Brokerage questions. You want to be in commercial, you want to be in residential, whatever you want. I've been there, done that, had 115 agents. And then buying your own rental properties. So Jackson, what was the first question?
It was, one second. How to make money in real estate.
All right, so how to make money in real estate. Here's the number one thing I would do. If you have a pen and paper, I'd write it down. I've learned in the human brain, if you don't write it down, it goes from one ear out the other. So I highly recommend it. So I dropped about $100,000 on real estate coaching, and I would leave events, and I would come out of events, and I would literally have 50 different things I wanted to do. I learned the human brain can only really implement two or three things at once. So I recommend when you take notes in class or take notes when you meet someone that has live experience, take notes, and on the right-hand side, write down three golden nuggets at the end of your presentation or after you speak, what you want to implement. Don't do it at the beginning, because what happens is that list just gets really, really big. Take all the notes, and on the right-hand side, three things that you really, really like that you want to implement. There's a great book, if anybody's a book reader, it's called Gary Keller, One Thing. Focus on one thing and kick butt at it. One thing. Just work on one thing and grow. That's a great note-taker one. Another great book's Compound Effect by Darren Hardy. He's a multi-millionaire. He owns a magazine called Success Magazine, you know? If you want his free daily messages, I highly, highly recommend it. There's nothing in this world that you could listen to in the morning or any podcast or any Facebook Live, anything more powerful than something as simple as a free message from a multimillionaire who's very, very successful in the sense of balance. It's not all about money. It's about balance and being happy in life. Darren Hardy is a classic example. So your question is, how do you make money in real estate? So number one, you got to find a mentor. Number one thing is I would find a mentor. Jackson, we were just talking before you came in up here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, my daughter is eight years old. She has two business coaches. She has two coaches already right now, fun coaches. This is not me putting this on. She's around this all the time. She understands the importance of it. One is Cleve Maddox. It's a kid who's 16 years old. Yeah. You know Cleve? Yeah. So he'll bring in about $1 million. He charges about $15,000 to $30,000 to speak. My one friend tried hiring him, so he's legit. And then the other one is my friend Lena, my friend Len. He made $49 million one year for a corporation in New York, did not like working for him, went down to Florida, became a builder. His kids made $70,000 when they were 16 years old. Legit, $70,000. Anyway, she's working with my daughter every 2 weeks on things that she wants to implement about life, how to be thankful, how to be polite, how to be balanced, how to help people, how to make money as a kid. And in those things, they both have a business coach. I have a business coach. I'm in a wealth building group. So you have to find a mentor. You never know everything. Just find someone who's a little bit smarter than you in a sense of age, not smarter in their brain, smarter in the age point where they've experienced, they've been through it. I like to find people who've screwed up because if people screwed up, they took chances. If they didn't screw up, they did not take any chances. There's two ways to live life, have regrets, no regrets. And number one, I'd find a mentor. So where would you find a mentor? Is that a fair statement? So if you wanted to get into real estate, you need to find a mentor. I would find a mentor at local real estate brokerages. You guys are very lucky. You have a lot of good real estate brokerages in Philadelphia. You have Fox and Rhodes. You have Coldwell Banker. You have Keller Williams. You have a lot of small firms. There's a lot of different brokerages you guys can find good mentors. Where would I look? I would look on Craigslist. Okay, I would look on Craigslist and I would offer to work for someone. I told Jackson, getting back to my daughter thing, I'm going to offer my daughter to go to college, and I also want to offer her to actually pay someone to work for free. I'd be willing to pay someone $30,000 to $50,000 a year to work beside them for free to allow them to work with my daughter. I believe the importance of a mentor is that much. I learned so much from mentors given me. I want to give back. I still have a lot more to learn from. The mentor is very, very critical. Are you willing to pay someone a lot of money to mentor you? So right now, if I was you guys and where you're at in your shoes, I'd be offering on Craigslist to work with someone for free in the real estate game. You'll get great experience from that, and it'll help you identify if you want to get commercial, residential, what you're going to do. Where I messed up is I went to pharmacy school, and all I knew was what I saw my dad, and I didn't see the school part, and it wasn't for me. Same thing in the real world. You might not have seen the real world part. I'd recommend getting out there right now, and there's plenty of real estate agents in Philadelphia and real estate investors that let you guys work with you for free and would pay you. So I'd highly recommend that. Is that cool? And Philadelphia is a great spot for it. So number one, how to get in real estate, I would find a mentor. Number two, you gotta figure out what your why is, and it's really, really hard. Jackson knows this. Jackson works with me, he goes to Temple. There's four guys in a group that go to Temple that work with us, right, mm-hmm. in the group. I would figure out what you're trying to achieve. And the hard thing is, you guys, you know, might not know what you want yet until you experience it. So until you physically date and get experience with the situation, then you know if you want to get married to it. So let me ask you a question. If you guys, anybody married here? So I'm the only married person. All right, cool. So I dated my wife before I got married, right? How often do you guys know someone gets married the first day they do something? Yes or no? They don't. How long do they typically take till they get married? This is interaction. Come on, guys.
Couple years,
right? Same thing in finding in jobs and finding a career in real estate. It's going to take you guys a couple years to figure it out. So the more you date and the more you interact with people, the more likely you guys will figure out what career you want to be in. Is that fair in real estate? So number one, you're going to find a mentor. Number two, you're going to try to figure out what you're doing. I would be reading a boatload of books. So my tip number two on what to get in real estate, here's the books I'd be reading. I'd be reading anything with Gary Keller is a great author of books. I'd be reading anything with Darren Hardy, H-A-R-D-Y. I would be reading anything Grant Cardone, C-A-R-D-O-N-E. You a book reader?
Yeah.
You know a lot of the successful people already. Who else I'd be reading? Slight Edge. That'll really help you with the morning routine if you're having challenges with the morning routines. That was, you just Google it. One great for college is 21 Ways to Stop Procrastinations. The book's called Eat That Frog, excuse me. Eat That Frog. 21 Ways to Stop Procrastinations. And then I'd jump on podcasts as tip number three. Podcasts, Real Estate Superstars. My buddy has a podcast doing that. My other buddy has, his name's Pat Hyban, H-I-B-A-N. Very, very successful person over the years. Health, wealth, happiness, and giving back. Very healthy man, over 50 years old right now, doing great. Millionaire Mindcap, or Millionaire Mindset. That's my buddy. He'll flip over 70 to 80 houses in a year. Young, Matty Atchison, Matty A. He's in a group that we're in a group called Go Abundance. It's a group on health, wealth, happiness, and giving back. So all these guys are in that group that I just mentioned. That's it. So podcast, find a mentor, and what was the third tip I gave you guys? Let's see if you're paying attention.
What's your why?
Yep, what's your why? There's a great book called Start With Why, Simon Sinek. Raise your hand if you're a millennial in here. Do millennials get good raps or bad raps from a business perspective? What do you think? Bad raps. I hate it. I can't stand it. Listen to Simon Sinek. I love millennials. Love them, love them, love them. The one brokerage I work with turned around and I found a lot of talent with millennials and found out how to work with them and how they want to think differently. Most millennials do not want to be put into a box. Is that a fair statement? Most millennials want to give healthy choice options and allow them to achieve those things and branch out and create things. That is one of the things I really learned. And Start With Why, he has a video on YouTube about that. Simon Sinek. Cool. So how do you get into real estate? That's, you know, three or four tips there. Anybody else have any questions on that? Real estate license, you guys know how to get a real estate license? You guys, Temple has a real estate school for that. Does anybody actually, I've met people that have a real estate license in college. Does anybody have a real estate license?
Almost?
Okay, almost. How do you get paid in real estate?
Commission.
Do you have benefits? No benefits. Do you get your taxes withheld? Nope. A lot of people have issues paying their taxes and then they get hit up with the IRS because if you make a check for 10 grand, how much money should you put away?
3 grand.
Who said that? Three? Yep, so 3 grand, dead on. You should at least be putting 30% away. No benefits, straight commissions, taxes. How much money does an average realtor in Philadelphia make? Let's restart that question. What's the average new realtor make in real estate?
Like 30.
Probably 30. 15% of the realtors make it 18 months. 15%. So what's the other 85%? What's the other 80? Why is the other 85% failing? What do you guys think?
They're not persistent with their efforts and they give up.
So that's one, persistence, efforts. What else? There's one common thing. You're almost there. I'm going to give you a golden nugget. Remember this tip that I gave you. Anybody date anybody? Okay. There's two ways to date. Date number one is, hey, you want to go out on a date? They say yes or no. Date number two is you ask the same person 10 times to see if they want to go out on a date. Fair? Rejection. You have to get used to rejection. So tip number one in real estate is, no one cares that you're a realtor. You're a dime a dozen in real estate. The difference between a person who makes it and doesn't is not afraid of rejection. Golden nuggets, $1 million tip right there. In life, don't get afraid of rejection. If someone hasn't said no to you 7 to 9 times, you haven't sold them. 1, 2, they fall out. All the successful people that I know that went to Temple that did very, very well in real estate, they did not care about rejection. Nikki Gigani, if you're watching this, you were a classic example of that. Other guys in the group that were with us for years at different colleges, I can't remember exactly where, Todd Miller, Nikki Gigani, Steve Stafford, Colin Conway, these guys that are with us right now, they're not afraid of rejection. So it's a confidence issue, right? As a perception, most human beings worry about what everybody thinks, right? The fair statement? How they dress, what's the label, what's going on? If you just eliminate most of that and you work with a group that doesn't care about rejection, you can make a lot of money. So I would say that's number one. What's the number two reason that only 15% make it?
Time management.
Close. Time management's right there. Put it up there. We'll give it to you. Time management. Managing their time. Who has challenges right now managing time? Come on. Raise your hand if you have management time issues. If you don't, you're not doing enough in the day. It's just normal. Do you think athletes have issues with time management? Do you think successful people? We all do. If you don't admit it, you're not doing enough work. So I recommend reading some books on time management and time blocking. We're working with that in a group right now on time blocking, how to get more things done in a day. And time block personal life, party life, business life, educational life, and health life. It should be broken up into 5 things. 6 obviously is work too. And then the last one is what? Well, you guys are sitting here right now. What's tip number 3? Atmosphere. Why'd you go to Temple? If Temple was in Punxsutawney or if Temple was in Scranton, maybe you wouldn't have went here. Fair statement? Huh? Very fair? Right? So atmosphere is critical and when you guys select something. When you look at situations, you want to determine where you want to date and what firm you want to work with. You need to check out the atmosphere to see if it's something you want to be a part of. If you don't want to be that person who's talking to you or helping you, don't listen to them. I had people in my life that used to give me tips. I was like, I don't want to be them. They're a dirtball. I don't care how much money they make. They're unbalanced. They're about to have a heart attack. And I don't believe in what they believe in. I don't want to listen to them. That's fine. Go find someone who you want to be. Right now, I'm 40. I love listening to people who are 45, 50, 55, 60, who are older than me, and then younger, too, that have done things better than I have done so I can learn from them. But if they don't have a lifestyle I don't want, I don't want to listen to them. Now, is anybody's goal, what's your goal? Some goal is to be a millionaire. Raise your hand if you want to be a millionaire. Raise your hand if you want to have a balanced life and you want to give back. Okay? There's all different ones. Or maybe you want to do both, right? Find that person that has what you want and just suck them dry and give back to them in a nice way and give them what they don't have and you'll get a lot out of it. Is that cool? So question number one was how do I get the real estate? I think I gave you guys some places to look, some options, a little bit about the business. What was question number two?
Residential versus commercial real estate.
All right, who asked that question? You did, right? What's your name?
Jim,
okay. Which way are you thinking right now?
Right now I'm leaning towards commercial.
Okay, here's the difference. Both are fantastic, it depends on your lifestyle. Residential, it's pretty much easier to get into. The barriers to entry is easier. The money's great. The barriers to entry is harder in commercial, the money's bigger. So it depends. For me, a guy from Punxsutawney, Western Pennsylvania, had 0 connections out here. Residential was a no-brainer, Jim, because I had to leverage the people that I knew. And I knew some people, and I knew I could help them make money.
commercial, I've been totally on my own. I had no connections, no parents, nobody in the money world that helped me get some big buildings and some referrals. So in residential, you can normally start making money 3 to 6 months. Commercial, your world, it could be a year or 2 years. Now, you could hit a home run in 6 months, but I'd recommend talking to Kenny Wheeler. He's a great person. He's a great success story. I forget where he went to college. It might have been here. I forget. But he's a Rittenhouse realtor. He'd be a good person to ask about that. Residential world is just easier because I'll give you an example, Jim. Do you have some friends?
Sure.
Do you have some friends' parents?
Yes.
There's his prospects. Right? So when you're 21, 22, whatever age you are, in residential world, you always have prospects. In the commercial world, why I didn't like telecom when I was selling telecommunications, only IT directors and CFOs or CIOs were my prospects. When I got into real estate, every single person I met was a prospect. Commercial world, not everybody's your prospects. That's the difference. A lot of times in the commercial world, Jim, people will go on a team, they'll learn, they'll do work for them, and then eventually become an agent. You know, I like you're asking this question already. If you have interest in it, I would start working with a commercial firm now in college, learning the ropes and see if you like it. Okay.
Are you destined for failure if you don't have any connections going into commercial real estate?
I don't think you're destined for failure on it. I just think the barriers of entry. Remember this tip. Dave Krieger, if you're watching this, you gave me this tip. The barriers of entry in residential real estate is easier. The barriers of entry in commercial is just harder and harder to overcome. That's all. So there's many successful people I know that weren't from here, but they had a longer period of time sales cycle to create business. When you sell an apartment building for $50 million, you're getting 3% of that and you get your cut of your firm. So the numbers are there. There's less buildings that is being sold. If you notice in the commercial world, there's less agents, at least I see, that are doing better. Where in residential, there's a bigger pool of agents doing better. There's less transactions in the commercial world. So it depends on your interests. I like both. I'm part of groups that have both, so it doesn't matter to me if it's residential or commercial. Just my background has been flipping houses, keeping rentals, and selling other people's houses. Those are my three things. What was the next question? Anybody else want to comment on that or a question about commercial versus residential? In the city, you got there's commercial firms. I mean, literally, if you just Google commercial real estate firms, if you guys posted something on Craigslist as simple as looking for a job in commercial real estate, work for free to prove my effort or whatever you want to post there, you will get people that comment back. Or if you look, they're looking for people right now for help. Anybody else?
Anything other than Craigslist you would go on? Like, is Craigslist like really like
that? Craigslist is good. Indeed is good. And LinkedIn's good. Right now, a person on those three sites right now. Facebook is good. We're on Facebook Live right now. It's my number one generator of money. I have friends that make fun of me. They'll make fun of this video when I see them on Saturday when I'm having drinks watching Penn State. Jeremy's on Facebook Live again. What was he doing? But then as soon as they're away from my other friends, you know what they come up to me and they say? Hey, Jeremy, how can I get involved in a house? Hey, Jeremy. Let me ask you a question about real estate. See, as humans, we want to, it was like growing up, the tough people were typically the wimpiest people, in a sense, their mindset, because they had to perceive everybody to think that they were tough. But their mind was the weakness because they had to perceive it through other ways, right? So Facebook Live, hands down, if you guys are not using Facebook Live and you want to get out to your people, to say, hey, listen, I would do a live video, Jim. If you want to get commercial real estate, like, listen, I talked to this guy, Jeremy, today. I want to do a live video. I've never done one. Have you ever done one?
Okay,
I've never done one. I want to reach out to my center of influence. Who in the commercial world right now watching this would be interested in me grinding it out and doing whatever you say? If you tell me to jump off a cliff, I will jump off a cliff because I'm that motivated to get into commercial real estate. Share it with me, and I'll introduce you to people in the commercial world, and you can get quick experiences off it. Right. Yep. What's another question? What was the next question?
Small firm versus big firm.
So small firm versus big firm. I've worked for them all, so I can answer this question. They both have the pluses, and they both have the minuses, right? Let's start off with the small firm. The small firms typically, maybe a little bit more flexible on things. Maybe they're more creative on things. But the negative is
they don't maybe have the support system as a larger firm does. Maybe they don't have an HR department. Maybe they don't have an accounting department. Maybe they don't have a conveyancing department, right? So when you're looking at it, it really determines what your unique ability is. So here's gold nugget number two for anybody that wants to have a balanced life. Figure out what your unique ability is. I'm 40, I just figured it out. Joe Evangelisti is, we'll send a thank you message after this. Joe actually taught me this. Joe does $34 million in real estate business a year. He'll flip 80 houses. He's at Haddonfield, Pennsylvania. And he was originally a residential realtor, now he's in real estate investing. And he says to me, Jeremy, what's your unique ability? Figure out your unique ability and take it from there. So when you're looking at these firms, figure out what your unique ability is. So what's your first name?
Eric.
If Eric's unique ability is, I don't even bring it up, just call it ABC. And that fits better with a small firm, then I'd highly recommend that. If his unique ability is DEF, and that seems to jive with a large brokerage, I would look at that. So I'll give you some names that I think, just to give you a shortcut in the city. In small residential firms, you have City Space, fantastic company. Spacing Company, they're called now. OCF, another great company. Ori, he's in South Philly, huge builder, great company. Those are two smaller residential firms that come off. There's many of them, sorry if I forget a couple, but there's a lot of them. On the larger firms, you got Coldwell Banker, you got Keller Williams, and you got Fox and Roach, and you got Remax. I used to work for Coldwell Banker. All my business, my wife's at Coldwell Banker, and all my realtor work, I do with my wife through Coldwell Banker. And then I'm over TCS Investments for doing my investment work. So I don't think there's a right answer. You don't really figure out what your unique ability is. What was the next question? Any other questions?
Real quick, as like my biggest weakness being like my lack of knowledge, what would be like a better learning experience, a smaller or larger firm? Like, or does it all depend? Like, your
find the person, find the mentor. I believe that no one has created anything for me. People have given me opportunities, and I've taken it and ran with it. My dad was a hard worker, helped me go to college, but he didn't make me successful in college. Graduated college, got an opportunity in telecom. My wife got me the job because I couldn't pass interviews in telecommunications. Got into real estate through a guy by the name Gary DeMedio, took advantage of it. Go down the list of mentors and coaches. Find the right person. Let me ask you a question. Who made that sweatshirt? Do you know, in Temple? No idea, right? Do you care? You probably care more that it's a comfortable sweatshirt, fair? It's the feel. Same thing with mentors and companies. Don't get stuck on the company, get stuck on the mentor. Nice. And the only way you can do that is remember this term called dating. Date. Date people. Date people on in real estate. Physically go on to Craigslist, Indeed. If anybody has questions afterwards, I'll give you guys some more places I would talk to. And physically go and meet them. Jackson, did we date before you like, all right, I wanna start hitting the phones, right? Right? Come over, come check this out, see if you like it. If you do, come aboard and we'll show you, right? That's the same thing. When you commit right away and then you're stuck there, where's your start?
Eric.
And you're stuck there, it's too late.
Right.
So you just wanna kinda, remember, you guys most likely should be offering your time to these people. Some people will pay you, Eric. Anybody else? This side's quiet, all the questions are coming here. What's up on the right-hand side?
What kind of properties do you find most profitable?
All right. So that's one of the questions, right?
Next one was how to get into real estate investing.
Okay, perfect. You just be ready. What's your first name?
Anthony.
Okay. So how to get into real estate investing. Is that fair? Okay. Who's got rich parents? All right. Who knows someone rich? All right. I didn't have rich parents. I had parents that did well, saved their money, but they weren't gonna give me money to do real estate investing. So what I did was, I got a little lucky and I got help from my father-in-law, and he actually helped me buy my first house. It appreciated, I pulled the interest out, the appreciation, took $130,000, turned it into about $400,000, okay? But I used the line of credit. So first off, what you need to do is you gotta find someone that's got a little bit of money, okay? When you're in college, the thing I would be doing is the complete opposite of what most people would do. So, Anthony, right? Anthony, most people are going to say this in life. I'm going to go find a wealthy person and ask them for money. And their response is going to be, Anthony, how old are you?
19.
Yeah, Anthony, I'm going to give you $300,000 and you're 19 years old to buy real estate. And the market's really hot right now. It can crash. And I'm 40 years old. What do you know more than I do?
Fair.
Right? Instead, Anthony, what I'd be doing is I would go up to, say, someone like Jeremy, who's 40, and say, hey, Jeremy, listen, I want to get into real estate investing. I'm willing to do whatever it takes to get invested. I just want a cut of ownership. What I would say to you, perfect. Let's get a house in 3 months. 19 years old, he'll own a house. Here's what I would do differently. Anthony, here's the deal. We're going to go grind it out and door knock these streets right around Temple. And you're going to knock on the doors. And we're going to give you a flyer and information. You're going to find an opportunity. If you find that opportunity, bring it to me. I'm the closer. Let me close the deal, and you'll get percentage ownership of the property. 3 months, you're an owner in real estate compared to being a wannabe real estate investor. Okay? That's option one. Option two is you hit the home run, and you find someone that's got money that'll lend you money, and you buy real estate. Right? Most of the times, you guys ever notice as you get older, you look one way, and it's right there. Like, you're looking, you're trying to figure it out. The gold rush back in the day, people were looking for gold. They didn't realize there was gold underneath their feet. They didn't know it. In Anthony's situation, you realize right now you could own real estate this year if you change your mindset. And your mindset would be, let me go find some guys and girls that would buy it if I found it. Right? Because before I gave you that tip, what would you have said if you want to get in real estate investing? Find money? Is that fair? So just change that mindset. Anybody else? How to get into real estate investing?
So in terms of like finding a property, more specifically geared to like flipping,
yeah.
How do you determine or what's your point where you say that if a certain property is worth flipping?
Okay. So certain property is worth flipping. Number one, it's going to come down. So you guys ready for this? Who likes to flip properties? Who would like to flip a property? Raise your hand. All right. It's sexy. Everybody likes it. Oh, TV shows are on it. You know, it's the number one thing. So on flipping houses, what percentage are you looking for? It all depends on the investor. I'm going to give you guys some examples. You ready? So example number one is some people would like to get 10 to 20% on their money. If you put money in the stock market right now, how much money could you normally get?
Eight's
a good one. How about seven? So I got one that's doing around 15, 16%. I got some others doing 5, 6. I think the good average number is 8. So if you went up to a person and you found an opportunity for real estate investing where they can make 10 to 15% of their money, they most likely, if they have a little bit of risk in them, would do that, right? Fair? What I do is I typically look for flips making 30 to 35% money. So.
So was that in like short sales and foreclosures and buying cash or?
Anything. So the next point I'll get to after the percentages, if you remind me, Anthony, I'll tell you ways to find these. Is that fair?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So percentages, 10, 15, we're doing 30 to 35%, 37%. What you want to do is you actually have to find the investor that wants that money. I talked to a hedge fund, you know, we got private money. I got our guys that got money. Some guys want to split the deal. So if I find a deal and there's 30% profit, I keep 15, they get 15. I put no money up. It's another way to get into real estate. I put no money up, and this is situation one, not always, this is just situation one, and we split the profit, okay? If I find the deal, I manage the project, I do everything, that's option one. Option two is, you go get someone that has money, and you give them 10 to 14% of their money. So if Anthony wanted $1 million or just make it 100 grand and he came to me and said, Jeremy, you pull money out of your IRA, I'll give you 12% of your money. If he gives me 12% and he can make 30 on a flip, how much did he just net? How much? 18%, right? The difference. So tip number two is find someone that's got money and give them about 10 to 12% of their money. Does that make sense? Tip number one is what? What's tip number one? How you do it? You split it. You find someone that's got money. You split the deal with them and you go half and half. Tip number two is you give them a line at 10 to 12%. Number three, Anthony, in your case is you find a deal, you put nothing in it, you let someone like me who has experience renovate it, and you just learn, and you get a percentage. I personally would not give anybody in the room, let me rephrase that. Has anybody flipped the house yet? How many?
Six or seven.
That's pretty impressive. It's 19.
Two.
Two? How old are you?
19.
That's impressive. Anybody else? All right. So if you had some experience, maybe, you know what I mean? But most likely, someone's going to want to have more in it because they're going to have to do it. So like, let's just say you still want more experience in your case, Anthony. And I'd like to ask you what the results are. It's great you did six, but I want to hear your results. I would say to Anthony, all right, dude, here's the deal. If you want to come in with me and you find the deal, I'll coach you, I'll mentor you, I'll charge you nothing. You get a percent ownership, and then I get a percent. I find the money, I renovate it, I use my GCs, I manage it, I'll teach the game. That's how we did in a brokerage world for years, is have people do X amount of deals underneath a mentor, and a mentor got paid a cut. When you're looking at brokerages, if they don't have that deal, they don't really have a mentor program. So what was your question then? Percentages, then you said what? How to find them? You said short sales?
Is it more profitable to do like short sales and foreclosures and buying cash rather than...
Who else would like to know where to find real estate deals right now in the month of November? All right, cool. So I can give you real world experience because I'm looking at about six this week, so I can tell you exactly where to find them all in Philadelphia, okay? So number one, which I'm going to... No order. I'm not a fan of this one, short sales. They take too long. So a short sale, bank, they're trying to pay the bank less than what they owe. So if they owe the bank 100, they're trying to pay the bank 80, you gotta negotiate with the bank, it could take a year to year and a half. That's one way to get a deal, because the bank will sometimes forgive debt and give it away. Two is auction sites. Auction sites, I'm gonna save you about, I don't know how many hours on this, I'll give you the real ones. Auction.com. Hubzu,
spell that for me.
H-U-B-Z-U, Hudson Marshall, Hudson, H-U-D-S-O-N, Marshall, in Philadelphia, Philadelphia County Sheriffs, and then in the suburbs, you each have one like Montgomery County. Those are the main ones. There's a ton of them. Cool. X-Home's a new one I saw. So where are you going to find most of them? Old school. Door knocking. Do you guys realize how much money you have right here? It's a gold mine. Sean Doyle, if you're watching this, dude, you sent me a deal today for about $1.2 million. Sean is literally, actually Sean went to Temple, we worked at a property management company in Temple. I highly recommend that too. Property management is another great way to get into real estate too. We have TCS Management, there's a lot of them right around here in Temple, which is awesome. You learn the market, you learn the investors. This guy did $7 million his first year. What's 7 million bucks? How much income is that in real estate? If you get paid 3%. See what Temple's teaching you math purposes wise. 7 million times 3%, how much commissions is that? 7 times 3 is 21, $210,000 bucks, right? $210,000, right? He gets his cut. First year. Second year, I think he told me he's gonna do $15 million. Where's 90% of his business? Right around this building. Temple right here has a ton. I have very, very many friends have done very, very well at Temple. When I went to Penn State, I never learned the real estate market, never realized how much money was sitting there. You guys have gold underneath your feet. Gold. You can graduate, you can do whatever you want in life. While you're in college, you have gold. And your job could be right now door knocking. If you asked me, number one thing, Jeremy, what would you be doing in college for a job? I would starve and I would door knock and learn real estate sales, and you would make a lot of money in college doing it. Starve first, because you're not gonna get paid until the deal goes through, right? So door knocking is the number one way. And most people have trouble door knocking because they hate what? Projection, and they don't want to get shot. Right? Knock on someone's door, you don't know. We got the cops called on Saturday, right? One of our guys got the cops. He stayed there while the cops... client just knock on the door and you're just asking, hey, you ever think about selling? I know an investor right now is thinking about buying. You know, it's pretty much like that, as simple as that. Yes, no, and then the next line, hey, you know the crazy people in the neighborhood you like to see leave? Tell you what, Jim, Eric, they're a pain in the butt. I like to see them. They party every night until 2 o'clock, and I've been trying to go to bed at 11. All of a sudden, you'll start to find who in the neighborhood is the troublemakers. And the guy sitting on the stoop that looks like he's half in the bag, it's a great person that gives you tips. He might be drinking a 40, but he knows what's going on in the neighborhood. What's he do all day? Came over to Eric's house, Susie came over, they literally know what's going on, right? They know everything, right? Those people we call bird dogs. Those people know everything in the street. So those are people I talk to. I give them coffee, I give them water, I talk to them, right? So you got door knocking, you got auction sites, you got short sales, you got banks, small banks, you got prospecting. You're going to call people that are behind on taxes, liens, things like that. You're going to find people's zoning purposes where you can make a lot of money. One reason why Temple does really good on money, let's see who knows this. What zoning is very, very good to make money off of in real estate? All right. Anything CMX? I'd write this down because if you come across a building. No. What else?
Commercial mixed use.
That's commercial mixed use. Good. And then RM1. I got a deal sent to me today, it was RM1. That means you can take the house down and you can build 4 units. I think my buddy Stafford went to Temple. Anyways, they have 35 projects right now, second year in the business off RM1. Do anybody know where Francisville is? No, I have no idea either. It's a gold mine. It's right next to Fairmount. You ever hear of Fairmount by Art Museum, right? Francisville's a little second, you know? It's your left-hand neighbor on the other side of Broad Street off of Fairmont Ave. That's Francisville. Well, there's little single houses over there on 19th and 20th that people were buying originally for $200. Now they go for $400, and they're building units in there, and they're selling them for $2 million. So you're in these projects for $1.2 million, and I'm an idiot and backed out of a deal last year because I thought I could get $1.5 million for it. They're renting them, and they're selling them for $2 million. I lost $800,000 on one house. Right? RM1 lots are gold because don't look at that house, look at what you can build. They're taking down one house and they're building 4 houses for $400,000 a pop. Cool? How much time do we have?
6
minutes. Right, cool. What was the other questions?
The last one was how to select like a great first property.
How to select the first great property. I don't think there's a right answer to that. Who asked that question? I don't think there's a good way to answer that, but I'd answer it this way. I'd get something that you know the area. Don't be an idiot like me and buy something in Brigantine, New Jersey because you didn't know the area and you wanted a beach house because you never had a beach house and you buy it and you lose $200,000. Don't be that idiot. What you should have done is I should have dated, should have rented, should have learned that market and then bought. Hurricane Sandy came, the market collapsed, I bought in a low elevation area. So to answer your question, where should you invest? I'd invest right here where you know. I'd buy something on the neighborhood. I'd buy something, you know, within a couple blocks from where you live right now. You guys know what's going on in your neighborhood.
What's your opinion of the rental properties where you live in one and rent out the other?
They're cool. I bought one at the beach doing that, a duplex. Yeah, it's a great way to get started. The challenge is right now the market's so hot. The market's turning. People don't see it right now. Guys, the market's turning. If you're watching this and you don't know it, you know, it's turning. 2006 to 2008, the market dropped. It took 2 years to drop. Right now it's turning, and it's turning for the worse. People can't see it, slightly. There's a lot of building going on. It's not gonna be overnight, but it's turning, mark my words. I sold a house in Rittenhouse in 2 days for $950, 2 weeks ago that I rehabbed. I have a property in Graduate Hospital that I had reduced by $50,000. I have some other places I just sold. They sold pretty quick. But remember, it's not overnight, right? Wars change the economy overnight. Is that a fair statement? People get scared. The economy normally takes time to turn. It's turning for the worse.
So after it turns or goes down, how long does it normally take to recover?
Last time it was 06 to 08, and then it turned back up, and then the last 2008
2017. It's been on a nice run now, probably for 6-7 years. You know what I mean? It normally will bounce. It took 2 years to go down. Took three more years. To answer your question, watch these markets. Watch New York. Watch California, and watch Florida. Florida and California normally turn before Philly.
You said the market's about to turn, so for like first time home buyers, or even people who've been there, already flipped houses, what would you say, like, in the means of like entering the markets right now? Like, do you recommend us buying a new house right now? Or do you say the markets are turning?
Absolutely. Buy cheaper. Always buy real estate. Just buy at the right price. It doesn't matter what the market is going for. When I lost money in Brigantine, I paid what it was worth that day. Today, I buy at a discount. I buy at 30%. So if the house is worth 100, I got to be in it for 70. Otherwise, I won't touch it. Because if the market turns 15, 20%, it doesn't matter. So every single house I have flipping right now, I'm renovating and flipping, it doesn't matter. And I have to make sure, because I'm doing this for other investors. We're going to flip 100 houses for investors. Do 40 flips, it's 140, and then rentals 15. We're gonna do 155 houses. If we pull that off, it's gonna be one of the largest in the area. I gotta make sure we're buying with profit in there, percentages, so if the market turns, people don't get crashed.
How are you going about, you said 30% discount, so how are you going about that, like negotiation? So like, what are you doing?
Negotiate off market. MLS is very, very hard to make really good money. You gotta find them off market. Anthony, you gotta door knock. You know, that would be my tip to him, is if he wants to get in the market, door knock's one of the best ways. Marketing material. I got guys that probably watch us that make that spend $15,000 to $25,000 a month in marketing, sending postcards.
Since we have to buy these properties with like capital, do you suggest like taking out a loan, or we should start off by making money through like being an agent and then use our own funds?
I would recommend that number one tip. This is probably the other golden nugget that Anthony talked about. I would find someone like me or someone else that you know that's in a real estate game. And say, listen, I want to learn it. I want to buy real estate with you. If I'm willing to go door knock, would you partner with me on my first opportunity and let me learn from you in the rehab? Let them give you 10, 20% stake in the game. If they're making $50,000, you just made $10,000. How long is it going to take you to be a realtor to make that $10,000? You could. That's another option. I love it. I love the real estate side, realtor side. I have a lot of experience in that too. But I'm just saying, if you want to get real estate investing quick, I'd recommend that and you'd learn it. Because a realtor and a real estate investor are two different things. A lot of people don't own real estate that are in the realtor business. One, they might just not know it, or B, they sell so much. When I built a team, I wasn't doing much investing because I was grinding 70 hours a week and selling. So I would find someone that you can partner with. I would not take a loan out. If someone gives you a loan, I would not take a loan out. It's like literally opening up a business with no experience. You're set up for failure. How much more time we got?
12:59.
All right, so here's the deal. We talked about experience. We talked about commercial, residential, flipping, rentals, turnkeys. Talked about companies. Talked about the market turning. Common mistakes. We talked about wins, questions. Any of this stuff that we talked about today, you can go on, just Google my name. It's J-E-R. J-E-R. E-M-Y. And the last name is Bowers, B-O-W-E-R-S. I have probably over 100 training videos for free on YouTube. I train realtors, train real estate investors. I've been doing this. Facebook, just type it in. You'll see I do a lot of live stuff on Facebook. I'll take people through rehab processes. You can see that. And if you have any questions after this and you want anything and you want me to connect you with a commercial person or residential, anything you guys need, like experience-wise, just let us know. I'm all about life, just trying to help connect people. If I can connect you, it has nothing to do with me. I probably won't make a dime off it. I don't care. The reason why I drove down here today is Adam, who works with us, went to Temple. I've had so many people be successful from Temple that I just wanted to meet you guys, because I know there's going to be a lot of people in this room who are going to do very well in real estate. And I hate to say this, TV and all this crap that most people give us is all fake. Big yachts and Porsches and all this crap. You can make that, but I want you guys to see something real, experience how it is right now in real estate. You can get there eventually, but right now really makes it so easy. So I wanted to be real with you guys today. Hopefully that was today. If you guys appreciate it, I'd love if you're on YouTube or Facebook. Today I'm on Facebook Live. You guys can just post a comment
can never pay me back, but one thing you could do is you could pay me back with just a nice comment. It goes a long way. Leave you with this. Anybody write thank you notes? Raise your hand. Okay. Thank you notes are all, wow, look at you. Wow, that's impressive. So thank you notes are almost dead. If you want to help someone, you want to get something free, any person you guys call for a job, send a thank you note. And the thank you note will stand out. A thank you email, they get barely. We get 300 emails a day. You know, a thank you email, great, good. You get a thank you note, I have every single thank you note in a folder. And Dave Krieger showed me one day in his office, he's the CEO of Coldwell Banker Preferred locally, he has every one. You want to get an opportunity, send a thank you card. So today, I'd send a thank you card and email to Justin. If you went on my YouTube or Facebook, you'll see the address. Send a thank you card, and trust me, I will go above and beyond to try to connect you with the right person so you guys can get some free experience in college. Is that cool? Anybody else? Well, what's next? Classes? Are you guys done for the day?
Interview.
Interview? Where are you interviewing?
CBRE.
All right, great company.
In 40 minutes, I'm nervous.
So let me ask you this one last question. Who is looking for a job opportunity right now? Raise your hand. Holy crap. Raise your hand one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12. So here's my goal. My goal is to help you guys get job interviews. Okay? I want you each to get 3. So that's 45 interviews. Here's my commitment to you guys today. I'm dead serious. Jackson, do I back up my commitments?
Absolutely.
45 interviews I want to get out of this. This is going to be a pretty cool challenge. Message me. And I'm going to introduce you to people, and I want to give you guys 45. Justin, remember this. I want to see if anybody ever does this and speaks to your group. I want you to hold me to it. We're going to keep track of it as a group. We'll keep it on Google Drive. Let's see if we can get you guys 45 interviews in the sense of either on the phone or in person talking to people. Is that cool? You get 3 dates. Out of the 3 dates, you guys are going to probably figure out what firm you want to work at. Is that cool? All right, so 45 is the goal. If we get 45, I don't know what we get. Pick some. What happens if we get 45? You're always gonna put some at the end. Why does anybody steal a car? Good, no. I still steal one. You don't want to go to jail. It's end results. I'm just joking. It's always end results. When you set a goal and you have something positive to achieve, you'll do it. So what's the goal if we get 45 interviews? Justin, let's get a limo bus and we'll go to AC for the night. No, I'm just
I don't have the funds.
You don't have the funds? I would do that. So we'll figure it out. So I'll keep in touch with Justin. Message me afterwards on Facebook, Jeremy Bowers on YouTube. I'll introduce you to people. Let's see if we can get you guys 45 appointments. And I'm going to get help to it because I got 4 guys in the crew that are at Temple, so they're never going to let me live this down. Is that cool? That's all I got. Have a good day. If anybody wants a business card, I got business cards here.
I wish I could stay longer, but I got that phone interview on there. All
right. Would you mind being
with the Absolutely, for sure.
Yeah, you too,
Keisha.
Man. Keisha, yeah, good meeting you. Yeah, message if you're looking. I'll introduce you to some people.
What's up, man? Thanks. How many 6 flips at 19?
Yeah, my dad and a couple of his friends do.
Thank you. Jay.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Hold on a second, real quick. Take a picture real quick. That.